rattlesnakes.
Rattlesnakes?
Yeah. Pygmy rattlesnakes specific. Jeez.
Watch out, there it is!
We're on location at the taping of a segment for Growing a Greener World TV. So let's watch.
All right, stand by, David. You wide, right?
Yep.
Stand by. And marker.
317, scene 5, take 3.
This is where she thinks that vegetable garden.
I'm sorry. I'm gonna. Don't cut the camera. Still roll it. Start over again. Just never forget the camera.
Yeah, forget we're here.
Okay, that's good.
I'm looking for snakes. All right, roll cameras, please.
All right, here we go. Stand by and action.
Yeah, the other thing is we have to convince your mother by showing her how beautiful an edible ornamental garden can be, because it's going to be gorgeous here. It looks as though this is going to be the sunniest spot in our whole yard.
Yep.
Talk about what we can do about that.
Well, I think one of the things we can do is take a look at this fantastic crepe myrtle she has. It's a focal, beautiful tree, but it's also encroaching on some of the sun here. So we could do a little bit of work on that, but yeah, that's fantastic. So
let's break right there.
So here we are, and Melissa's come by here and honored us with her presence here at this taping of one of the episodes of Growing a Greener World. We're doing it on garden coaching. So we're in Atlanta, and this is going to be a good episode.
Is going to be a good one.
You're documenting this as well, right?
Yes, I am. And we're talking about maybe putting some vegetables in the front yard along with the perennials and what's the pros and cons about it.
Yep.
And this is Joe Lamplin, y'all, by the way. If you don't already know Joe, you need to.
Thank you. I like to change the subject when we start talking about me. But one of the cool things about this episode is that the homeowner, Emily, loves to have edibles, but there's this conflict between her and her gardener mother, who knows a lot as well, in that she wants more perennials and thinks that the edibles may not be as attractive in the front yard. But one of the things we're going to reveal in this episode is the fact that you can have the best of both worlds, and you can have a great edible ornamental garden right in your front yard on the street. So we're looking forward to talking more about that.
I'm excited.
Yeah. So what are you going to do with for us today? You're just going to, this is Carl. This is the camera shooter buddy that we always bring along for the shows.
Director of photography.
He's picky about his title, but he does a great job. And so we got a nice crew here. Everybody's behind the scenes right now getting set up for the next shot. But
hey, guys.
For coming. Yeah, here's Robin. This is our expert from Seattle. Now, she's the garden coach with Garden Mentors. That's her company. But we brought her in from Seattle. She got in late last night, and she's going to be
It's early for me.
Yeah, 8:30 her time, 11:30 our time. Not so early. But she's going to be the guest expert here that's going to show us everything that we need to do if we're a homeowner on how to do more in our gardens.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And do more successfully.
Yeah.
Be better stewards of the planet.
Yep.
All that good stuff.
All right.
All
that good
have
stuff.
More success.
That's right.
Yeah.
So, Emily, tell us a little bit about what you're wanting to do. Well, basically, I am hoping to get some suggestions on how to deal with not having enough light for my vegetable garden, get some ideas about what to do with the deer that are destroying my garden, work on the horrible soil in my garden, you name it. That's just part of my issue. Okay.
Okay, well, first of all, I love your crepe myrtle here. Thank you for not cutting that back. Uh-huh. It's a universal problem, but we have a solution for that, and it's on our website under the show notes for this episode. The website address is the same as our name. It's growingagreenerworld.com.
Good.
You got the sound effect from the shotgun you're talking.
There's some mosquitoes around here.
Serious.
I think I sweated off, but off.
You got a lot of editing to do yourself. What do you edit in?
I just have some real product colors.
So flip it over on the white side. You guys can
step
right there. And come more my way.
Yeah.
There, right there. Even
Great job over there. You're making us look good.
Who? What?
All right, here we go. Stand by. And action.
We can
wait a second. Hello,
hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello.
So we've given a lot to think about. Is this pretty typical for your clients?
Sure. You know, she's got a lot of the questions, blah, okay. blah, blah. Right.
We've given Emily a lot to think about, haven't we?
We sure have.
So is this typical of your client's situation?
She's got some typical questions and typical issues, but every site is different.
Yeah, so she's well on her way. A lot more to do. Gardener's work is never finished, right?
No, never. We're all committed.
Good.
You want to do it one more time?
Yeah.
Kudos to her.
Yeah, gardener's work is never done.
Never, but fun.
Yeah, that it is.
Okay, Emily, thank you so much for letting all of us come out. And we had fun with the Growing a Greener World TV. And we got free pruning out of it. Check that out. We got the big pile of pruning done. It looks so much better.
And the tree looks way better.
It looks fantastic. It does. And this is Poodle Power on Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
And I am at Gardenmagik on Twitter. And thanks, Emily.
Thank you.
And I want to say thank you so much, Joe. And thank you so much.
Oh.
Y'all, this is amazing.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks for coming
It's amazing
out.
For us.
It's great.
To have
it's
you great. Here.
Thank you, Jeff.
All right.